Daniel Sullivan. I'm the vicar for clergy for the Archdiocese of Philadelphia. I've also been canonically appointed by Archbishop Chaput as the special notary for this public opening session of the special tribunal that has been canonically established by Archbishop Chaput to investigate the heroic life and holiness of the servant of God, Father William Atkinson, priest and professor of the Order of Saint Augustine. The work of the tribunal begin formally tonight, and in the months ahead, we'll thoroughly investigate the life of Father Atkinson as his cause for beatification and sainthood begins. The purpose of tonight's event is primarily for the Archbishop and the members of the tribunal he has established, as well as the promoter of the cause, to take their oath of office, and for everyone here to be reminded of Father Atkinson's life as his archdiocesan phase, his cause for beatification and sainthood begins. As this opening session begins, I invite Archbishop Chaput, the Archbishop of Philadelphia, to begin an opening prayer.
You can remain seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us begin. O Spirit of wisdom, preside over all our thoughts, words, and actions. Spirit of understanding, enlighten and teach us. Spirit of counsel, direct our inexperience. Spirit of fortitude, strengthen our weakness. Spirit of knowledge, instruct our ignorance. Spirit of piety, make us fervent in good works. Heavenly Spirit, make us preserve, persevere in the service of God, and enable us to act on all occasions with goodness and kindness, charity and joy, with long-suffering, mildness and fidelity. Let the heavenly virtues of modesty, continency, and chastity adorn the temple you have chosen for your abode. Spirit of holiness, by your all-powerful grace, preserve us in your goodness and help us fulfill always your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
And before the formal proceedings begin, I now ask Father Don Riley to come forward and read the brief following statement about Father Atkinson's ministry.
When asked, how long did it take for you to accept the fact you were never going to walk again, Bill Atkinson said, you never really accept it. Every night when you were put to bed, you hope that tomorrow is the morning that you get up and walk. What you learn to accept is that you don't get up and walk. When asked, how long did that take? Bill Atkinson replied, about 5 years. Life is like a card game. You either play with the cards that you have been dealt, or you fold, and I am not ready to fold. Bill Atkinson was born and raised in a suburb of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Having been taught by the Augustinian friars, Bill heard God's call to follow him as a member of the Augustinian community. In 1963, Bill entered the Augustinian formation program at the Augustinian Novitiate in New Hamburg, New York. It is here that the course of Bill's life would change drastically. February 22, 1965, Bill headed out with several other novices to Mount Toboggan. He was seated in its first position. As the toboggan descended the long course that had been devised earlier in the year, it veered from its path and struck a tree. As the other novices picked themselves up, Bill remained on the ground, unable to move, his spine broken. His doctor noted that Bill was the most severely injured quadriplegic he had ever seen. The Augustinian community, especially Bill's classmates, rallied around him. And over the next 9 years, they helped Bill through formation in the seminary. To be ordained to the priesthood, Bill needed a dispensation from the Holy Father. In his letter to Pope Paul VI, the young Bill Atkinson made clear his faith. In the long months of recuperation after my accident, I was not only blessed with much time in silence for prayer and reflection on the mysterious will of the Father, but also I was exposed to the love of Christ expressed through others. The response of others to my situation assured me of the Father's love, turned what many considered a stumbling block into a stepping stone. As my theological studies have progressed, I have come to appreciate the mystery of God's salvific will for us, and I have become more and more convinced that I am being called to serve this priest. From my physical condition, the Lord is obviously calling me to a very special vocation, closely conformed to his own cross. It is my conviction that in this modern age, where the dignity of human life is measured by productivity, where suffering should be eliminated at all costs, we must more than ever preach Christ crucified. We must witness to a suffering world that it is only through Christ's example that we can be saved. That is, to be saved on Easter Sunday, each one must pass through Good Friday. I await your reply with great faith, knowing full well that the Lord has been working through me and will continue to work through me for his own purposes. Let it not be my will, but his that is done. 6 days after the petition had been submitted, the dispensation was granted. Of Father William Edward Atkinson, a colleague, former baseball coach, and a friend of a half century, wrote, "He was given a heavy cross. He chose to accept it in a joyful manner. He taught, preached, visited the sick, buried the dead, baptized, counseled, advised, officiated at marriages, obeyed, listened, and prayed. True, there are many priests who do those things, but not with his cross. Father Bill lived the stations of the cross." In an occurrence that might serve to sum up Bill's whole life and ministry, days after he was ordained to the priesthood, he received a letter through a confrere from an admirer, Archbishop Fulton Sheen. Bill had met Archbishop Sheen in 1969 in Rochester, New York, at the ordination of that same confrere. After the Mass, Archbishop Sheen spoke with Bill, who would never share what that great man had said to him, but perhaps we could gain some insight into that exchange from the letter the Archbishop sent a few years later, acknowledging his delight at Father Bill's ordination. "Most of us are merely priests. Father Bill Atkinson will be a priest victim, which is the way our Lord wants all of us to be."
At this time in the opening session of the tribunal, we'll now begin the formal acts of the proceedings of this session. In the name of God, amen. Present today in this year of our Lord 2017, the fourth of the pontificate of our Holy Father Francis, on his 24th day of April at 6 p.m. in the Church of Saint Thomas of Villanova, located in Villanova, Pennsylvania, which is located within the Archdiocese of Philadelphia, are the following: His Excellency the Most Reverend Charles J. Chaput, Archbishop of Philadelphia, as well as the following members of the tribunal canonically established for the archdiocesan phase, whose work is to investigate the heroic life and virtues of Father Atkinson: Reverend Gregory T. Finn, Congregation of the Oblates of St. Joseph, Episcopal Delegate of the Archbishop; Reverend Monsignor Gerald C. Measure, promoter of justice, duly cited, Reverend James M. Oliver, substitute notary, all named by decree of His Excellency, the Archbishop of Philadelphia. Also present today is the Reverend Joseph Scaparis of the Augustinian Fathers, who has produced his appointment as postulator general of the Order of St. Joseph, St. Augustine, and the supplex labellus, by which Father Scaparis formally petitioned the Archbishop to initiate this cause of beatification and canonization of Father Atkinson. Father Scaparis has addressed respectful instances to the process of the life and virtues especially, as well as on the miracles of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of St. Augustine, might rightfully begin. Father Scaparis has asked that everything that is necessary and opportune for this purpose be done. I'll now read the supplex labellus written by Father Scaparis and addressed to Archbishop Chaput on September 15, 2015, in which Father Scaparis petitioning Archbishop Chaput to introduce the cause of beatification and canonization of Father Atkinson. Your Excellency, the undersigned, Father Joseph Scaparis, O.S.A., Postulator General of the Order of St. Augustine, in the name of the Prior General of the same order, Most Reverend Alejandro Morel Antone, having the intention to initiate the cause of beatification and canonization of William Atkinson, religious priest of the Order of St. Augustine, ask Your Excellency to introduce the cause according to the norms prescribed. The reputation of holiness of William Atkinson is well known to all those who had the privilege of being close to him during his lifetime and came to know him after his death. Born in 1946, he joined the Augustinian Order in 1964. During his novitiate year, he was almost completely paralyzed due to a toboggan accident. Determined to serve the Lord, he continued his formation, professing simple vows in 1970, solemn vows 3 years later. He was ordained a priest 3 years later with a special dispensation from Pope Paul VI, thus making him the first quadriplegic to do so. During his 30 years stay at Monsignor Bonner High School, a Catholic high school of the Archdiocese of Philadelphia, staffed by the Augustinians, he served in several posts. Known for his wonderful sense of humor, but also for his deep prayer and spirituality, he was a true Christian inspiration to many until his death in St. Thomas Monastery at Villanova University on September 15, 2006. William Atkinson's life was a continued iridation of charity. His mission, especially among students at Monsignor Bonner High School, was all about forming young people in the maturity of faith. William Atkinson would have understood well and fully agreed with Your Excellency's statement, Catholic education is about making saints, about sowing the seeds of virtue and truth. Anything less cheats our students of their dignity. As many who remember him would say, he spent all his energy in favor of the young students who were entrusted to him, sharing with them the joy of serving the Lord in the Augustinian religious life. The Church constantly places before us new models of holiness for the glory of God, for the benefit of the faithful. Models of holiness encourage the Christian community to live and witness the gospel message. The life and work of William Atkinson are strong signs of hope for our society. During Father Atkinson's lifetime, death, and the years following his return to the house of the Father, reputations of holiness never ceased. On the contrary, it increased, as one can see from the many diligent initiatives that the faithful spontaneously took in order to commemorate this holy Augustinian friar. Considering all of the above-mentioned reasons, by virtue of my office on behalf of the Order of St. Augustine, which constitutes itself as the actor of the cause, I humbly ask Your Excellency to introduce the cause according to the current laws of the Church. Signed, Father Joseph Scaparis, Postulator General of the Order of St. Augustine. His Excellency Archbishop Chaput, at the request of the Promoter of Justice, has examined the appointment as Postulator General of the Order of St. Augustine and the supplex labellus, and he has given them to the Episcopal Delegate and the Promoter of Justice, that any just reason for refuting them they have been shown. nothing contrary having been found in these documents, Archbishop Chaput now declares these documents legal and authentic. This declaration having been made, the Archbishop now authorizes the substitute notary of this tribunal to notarize them, to notarize these documents at the end of this session. The Archbishop also confirms all the officials of this tribunal who have been chosen and appointed to their respective offices by decree. Archbishop Chaput and the officials of the tribunal will take their respective oaths of office during this opening session in order that they might accept the charges given them and declare themselves ready to begin the process at hand, indicating they are willing to carry it out faithfully and observe the confidentiality attached to this respective offices. I, Monsignor Daniel Sullivan, will now read the letter of the Congregation for the Cause of the Saints, dated June 23, 2016, an address to Archbishop Chaput, in which is stated that on the part of the Holy See, there is no obstacle whatsoever to the introduction of the cause of the beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine. Most excellent Lord, by a letter sent to the Congregation for the Causes of the Saint, Your Excellency inquires whether on the part of the Holy See anything might obstruct the cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine, whose life was completed in the year of our Lord, 2006. If the matter having been examined, it pleases me to return greater certitude to Your Excellency that on the part of the Holy See there is nothing to obstruct the cause of beatification and canonization of the same servant of God from being able to be completed with the norms issued by this same congregation having been observed. Signed most devotedly in yours and in the Lord, Angelo Cardinal Amato, Prefect. Now I'll read Archbishop Chaput's decree, by which Archbishop Chaput decreed the introduction, the cause, and the creation of the tribunal. There's a lot of stuff here. The cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of St. Augustine. Decree of introduction of the cause and the creation of the tribunal. I, Most Reverend Charles J. Chaput, O.F.M. Cap, Archbishop of Philadelphia, having seen the suplex libellus of September 15, 2015, by which Father Joseph Scabellus, O.S.A., postulator general of the Order of St. Augustine, and therefore the cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, a professed priest of the Order of St. Augustine, requested the introduction of said cause. Having heard my brothers in the episcopate of our ecclesiastical region, and completed the necessary and adequate inquiries, convinced of the sound basis for the cause and the absence of significant obstacles against it, as stipulated by the Nihil Obstat of the Congregation of Causes of Saint on the 23rd day of June 2016, I decree the introduction of the cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine, and the order that the process of this life, of his life, virtues, and reputation, holiness of the servant of God be open according to the same norms of existing legislation. Moreover, with the present decree, as members of the tribunal, I appoint Episcopal Delegate, the Reverend Gregory T. Finn, Promoter of Justice, the Reverend Monsignor Gerard C. Mesher, as Notary, the Reverend Sean P. Bransfield, as substitute notary, the Reverend James M. Oliver. The Chancellor of the Diocesan Curia will inform them of their appointments in order that all appear on the 24th day of April 2017 at 6 p.m. in the Church of St. Thomas of Villanova on the campus of Villanova University, Villanova, Pennsylvania, in order to receive the obligations for which they have been chosen, take their oath, and participate in the first session of the acts according to which is provided for in this decree. Given at Philadelphia, the seat of the Episcopal office, the 27th of March, 2017. Ms. Reverend Charles Chaput. Archbishop of Philadelphia. I'm now going to invite Archbishop Chaput, Archbishop of Philadelphia, in case I didn't say that already, to pronounce and sign his oath of office.
In the name of our Lord, I, Charles Joseph Chaput, O.F.M. Capuchin, Archbishop of Philadelphia, swear to fulfill faithfully and diligently the charge given to me in the process concerning the life and virtues, especially, not only of miracles in general, of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine. I swear as well to keep secret all those things which could defame the servant of God or other persons, and concerning the depositions of witnesses, and not to speak of them except with the officials of the tribunal named in this process. I swear finally not to accept any type of gift that might be offered me because of this present process. So help me God.
Now invite Reverend Gregory Finn of the Diocese of St. Joseph, Episcopal Delegate, to pronounce and sign his oath of office.
In the name of our Lord, I, Gregory Thomas Finn, of the Oblates of St. Joseph, swear to fulfill faithfully and diligently the charge given to me in the process concerning the life and virtues, especially not only of miracles in general, of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of St. Augustine. I swear as well to keep secret all those things which could defame the servant of God or other persons, and concerning the depositions of witnesses, and not to speak of them except with the officials of the tribunal named for this process. I swear finally not to accept any type of gift that might be offered me because of this present process. So help me God.
Now invite Mr. Jared Measure, promoter of justice, to pronounce and sign his oath of office.
In the name of God, I, Jared C. Measure, swear to fulfill faithfully and diligently the charge given to me in the process concerning the life and virtues, especially not only of miracles in general, of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine. I swear as well to keep secret all those things which could defame the servant of God or other persons, and concerning the depositions of witnesses, and not to speak of them except with the officials of the tribunal, named for this process. I swear finally not to accept any type of gift that might be offered me because of this present process. So help me God.
Now invite Reverend James Oliver, substitute notary, to pronounce and sign his oath of office.
In the name of our Lord, I, James M. Oliver, swear to fulfill faithfully and diligently the charge given to me in the process concerning the life and virtues, especially not only of miracles in general, of servant of God William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine. I swear as well to keep secret all those things which could defame the servant of God or other persons, and concerning the depositions of witnesses, and not to speak of them except with the officials of the tribunal named for this purpose. I swear finally not to accept any type of gift that might be offered me because of this present process. So help me God.
Now inviting Monsignor Jared Measure, promoter of justice, to present to Archbishop Chaput and Father Finn, Episcopal delegate, the questions that will be used in the examination of the witnesses who will testify before the tribunal. Invite Reverend Joseph Scabaris, postulator general of the Order of St. Augustine, to present to the Archbishop and Father Finn the list of witnesses that should be questioned by the tribunal, keeping in mind that Father Scabaris retains the right to present additional names of potential witnesses to testify should they be discovered. Now I invite Father Scabaris to take his oath of office.
In the name of our Lord, I, Reverend Joseph Chaput, postulator in the cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, professed priest of the Order of St. Augustine, swear to fulfill faithfully the responsibility entrusted to me. I swear as well not to say or do anything which directly or indirectly might offend justice or limit the freedom of the witnesses. I swear, finally, to keep the secret to which all those who have a part in this process are held. So help me God.
Now introduce the three members of the Historical Commission, and soon I will invite each of them to come forward and take their oath of office. The members of the Historical Commission will work under the auspices of this tribunal and will specifically work to gather any and all historical documents, writings, and any other materials that pertain to Father Atkinson's life and any other documentation that may directly or indirectly be useful to investigate the servant of God's life and virtues. They will be presented to the tribunal along with a report by the members of the commission summarizing what has been discovered. And this report will also authenticate the accuracy of all these historical materials. The three members of the Historical Commission who have been appointed to this office by Archbishop Chaput are as follows: Reverend Joseph G. Ryan, Assistant Professor of History at Villanova University, President of the Historical Commission; Dr. Patrick J. Hayes, Archivist of the Baltimore Province of the Congregation of the Most Holy Redeemer; and Dr. Nicholas Rademacher, Associate Professor of Religious Studies at Reading University. I now invite Father Joseph Ryan to come forward and take his oath.
In the name of our Lord, I, Reverend Joseph G. Ryan, O.S.A., named by Archbishop Charles J. Chaput, Capuchin, Archbishop of Philadelphia, in the cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God William Atkinson, a professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine, a member of the Committee of Experts in History, swear that I will faithfully fulfill the position entrusted to me. I also swear to keep the obligated secret. May God in these holy gospels help me, upon which I place my hand.
And now I invite Dr. Patrick Hayes to come forward and take his oath of office.
In the name of our Lord, I, Patrick J. Hayes, named by Archbishop Charles J. Chaput, O.F.M. Capuchin, Archbishop of Philadelphia, in the cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, a professed priest of the Order of Saint Augustine, a member of the Committee of the Experts in History, swear that I will faithfully fulfill the position entrusted to me. I also swear to keep the obligated secret. May God and these holy gospels help me, upon which I place my hand.
Now I invite Dr. Nicholas Rademacher to come forward and take his oath of office.
In the name of our Lord, I, Nicholas K. Rademacher, named by Archbishop Charles J. Chaput, O.F.M. Capuchin, Archbishop of Philadelphia, in the cause of beatification and canonization of the servant of God, William Atkinson, a professed priest of the Order of St. Augustine, a member of the Committee of the Experts in History, swear that I will faithfully fulfill the position entrusted to me. I also swear to keep the obligated secret. May God and these holy gospels help me, upon which I place my hand.
now call upon Father James Oliver, substitute notary, to make a declaration.
Now that the oath of office has been taken and the list of questions to be used in the examination of the witnesses, as well as the list of witnesses to be questioned, have been presented to Archbishop Chaput and Father Finn, I now declare that subsequent meetings of this tribunal are to take place at the Archdiocesan Pastoral Center, located in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, or at another suitable place. As regards dates and hours of these subsequent meetings, all weekdays are possible, noting, moreover, that changes can be made to such meeting dates and times according to circumstances. Furthermore, when the next meeting date and time of this tribunal is established, I, as notary, am charged to inform the promoter of justice, as well as the witnesses scheduled to be interviewed, so that they can be present to offer their testimony.
And finally, as the notary of this opening session of this tribunal, I declare that I am obliged to faithfully record the minutes of what has transpired during the course of this present session, and to deliver them, along with the corresponding documentation related to this opening session, to the notary. I now invite Archbishop Chaput to come forward and offer his final remarks.
We're almost finished. First of all, I want to thank Almighty God, who has made this day possible. I also wish to thank God for the gift and witness contained within the life of Father Atkinson, whose goodness, virtue, and holiness of life have also made this day possible. This is a wonderful day in the life of both the Archdiocese of Philadelphia and the Augustinian Order. And my prayer is that as this cause of beatification and sainthood for Father Atkinson begins, it will serve as a source of rich and fruitful blessings for our local church. I wish also to thank Father Riveras, the Pastor General, who has helped us so very much, as well as Father Joseph Farrell, a local son who is Vicar General of the community and who represents the Prayer General of the Order of St. Augustine today, Father Michael Di Gregorio, our local provincial, who we love very much, of the province of St. Thomas of Villanova, the members of the tribunal gathered here today, as well as everyone who works so diligently to make this day possible. And in a very special way, I want to thank and acknowledge Father Atkinson's family and the friends who are present. Perhaps the members of family could stand so that we see you and can acknowledge your presence. Please, the family members, please stand. Thank you very, very much. We ask that Father Atkinson intercede for all of us and for our intentions as we go forth from here as a community of faith. So let us conclude with a prayer for Father Atkinson's beatification and canonization. I think you have it on your programs, and it's on the back of the program. If we could pray that together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Blessed are you, Father of life, source of goodness and peace, in whom all creation has its origin, and by whom every person is loved. In Father Bill Atkinson, your mercy and compassion were made manifest as he brought solace to the suffering and hope to the needy. By carrying the cross of life faithfully, he proclaimed confidence in your love and conformity to your will, and so drew others to you and to the generous gift of your grace. Hear our prayers offered through his intercession, so that as your work continues unfolded among us, bring honor to you, comfort to your people, and according to your will, glory to your servant. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.